He owned this instrument and that instrument. He owned it all.
You can run on.
So Trent Reznor's Nine Inch Nails made dance music for 7 years. And a few more years. And sometime at the end of Johnny Cash's career, he performed Hurt.
Go and tell that midnight rider, tell the rambler, the gambler, the
Nine Inch Nails is nothing like Johnny Cash's music. But it is related because all music has similarities to it. But they're extremely subtle.
Well, my goodness gracious,
they're not in the same same genre of music.
With the midnight dew, I've been down on bended knee, talking to the man from Galilee.
Rick Rubin said, you can play this and you can play that, and we'll do it, and we're going to record it.
That's when Nashville dumped him.
He was dumped by some previous record executives or whoever, lawyers or somebody.
His longtime record company dumped him.
Yeah. And a rapper producer picked him up, Rick Rubin.
Yeah.
And made a fortune off of it because he wouldn't have had any final record, period, if it wasn't for him or another producer. And no other producer obviously showed interest in him. Period.
Well, I don't think anybody thought they could approach it. I don't think
he's the only one that wanted to work with him was Rick Rubin.
Yeah.
Nobody else wanted him, period.
I've got the Rick Rubin record CD.
We got about four of them.
Yeah.
And they're all on the same record label that put out a lot of rap records a long time ago. Like, I guess, Run DMC and Beastie Boys. Because that's who produced that music. But Trent Reznor could pretty much... Trent Reznor basically is the Beatles of the 1990s. He single-handedly put out three records with a computer, whatever recording system he's using, and his trained mind and trained instrument understandings.
Yeah.
And put out one of the baddest years of music.
Yeah, he did. You know, Johnny Cash did Rusty Cage.
Rusty Cage, and that's Soundgarden.
And Personal Jesus.
And Soundgarden is recently passed away, the singer of Soundgarden. Oh. Back when we worked for John and we were in Gluckstadt working with the fucking Langley. Lanky. That's when he died. This one is probably his best song out of all of them. It's real like the Beatles, or real like the Abbey Road shit. Right there is real good. See where the video is pointed at? That one's a good one. That's my favorite one. This one's good. Right here, son. Just as good as Led Zeppelin. halfway like his name, instead of just some scribble. This one's a good one. Hey, look at him. This is his first tour out with his wife. What a mess I'm in. The only reason this is on the internet, because somebody videotaped it off their VCR back when you could get shit like this off a satellite, or a TV crew made it, and there's somebody 35 years later said, I'm fixing to stick it on the internet. Because Paul didn't stick this shit on the internet. Yeah. But it's professionally made, so obviously if somebody has a copy, they pick it up there. You know what kind of bass that is, right? You played the Hoffman, but that's not good. That is not the Hoffman. It's a Rickenbacker. Did you know over 60 years ago, Rickenbacker was spelled differently? Yeah, you didn't know that, did you? Now you know. He had to actually teach his wife how to play everything.
Yeah.
She She had no idea how to do any of it. She had no clue. Period.
Yeah.
And that almost supports the claim that he's from the future and traveled back here. So he could fake his own death and kill John Lennon for the time travel trade. But I don't believe that. I believe that Paul was just Paul and he grew up with John. What a mess I'm in. This is one of my favorite songs by Paul, period. It sounds good. One of the real good ones, the Neil Young was real good. He's the one that's good. Decade. Remember Decade?
Huh?
Decade, the record.
Decca?
Decade. The two disc set for Neil Young.
Oh.
The Neil Young Greatest Hits, two discs. It's called Decade. It's called Decade. Decade, Decade.
Okay, I didn't know that. I don't remember that.
We've got a brown color to the front of the record. Neil Young. There it is, Decade Songs. There it is right here, see? There it is. Full album. You remember that CD? Watch. Look. Look.
Adventure Kids Camp. We're exploring all kinds of places, making and eating awesome food, getting super crafty, and learning lots of cool facts every week. Get started at Kroger.com.
He took off. Him and Graham Parsons took off bigger than everybody. Graham Parsons was the big shit of the 1970s. Look at the dog. Dog. Why is this record got all the speckles on the picture? real young. You can tell who his influence is. His influence is right.